Airsoft, a global battle sport based on the use of replica weapons that fire low-velocity plastic ammunition. Gaining in popularity for over 50 years, I started to ask myself, where did Airsoft come from? And today, we're gonna talk about sniping. No, not that far. I mean to Clarence Hamilton and the Daisy Air Rifle. And if you had seen my previous video, you would know that this is the first all-metal spring-powered BB gun.
Boing.
And that it was produced by a windmill manufacturing company. But what I didn't mention is that this rifle was absolutely free. Sort of. You see, originally it was a promotional item that was given away after you purchased one of their windmills. Not unlike what you see a lot today with YouTubers.
I'll do a giveaway for this video, and it might be the ASG CZ Scorpion.
I love giving away airsoft guns, it's my favorite thing to do.
Just give one away already.
Giveaway going on.
We're doing a giveaway.
I'll be giving this gun away
to give the product away to one subscriber.
I'm giving away a modified gas blowback PP2000.
Giveaway.
But there was just one problem with this business model. Nobody was buying any f***ing windmills. So fast forward a few decades, and Daisy releases their new Bennett model, which is based on the Winchester repeating carbine, which led to this, and then this, which is where our story starts. The first toy replica rifle that fires a plastic projectile. Now I know this isn't a sniper rifle. But this one is the Johnny Eagle, which sounds American as a mother. Anyways, this replica toy gun was marketed as a hunting rifle where you could pretend to hunt endangered animals. Sounds like a good time to me, I guess.
How dare you?
Anyways, despite the company's best marketing efforts, this gun just didn't sell well and just ended up being a total flop. But that's okay, because it leads us to the next step in airsoft sniping evolution. The Asahi M40 Airsoft Sniper Rifle, which was made by a small company in Japan in the 1980s called Asahi, who is now sadly closed down. But the story of this rifle is infamous. With an ultra-realistic wood and metal construction, this truly unique propulsion system stemming from its cap gun origins, the Asahi M40 is truly a one-of-a-kind and is undeniably the rarest airsoft gun on Earth, with only 20 examples still in existence today. What made the Asahi M40 truly unique was its propulsion system. You see, today it's common for airsoft sniper rifles to use a spring or even have gas stored in the bolt. But with the Asahi, the gas was stored in the cartridge, which would be filled with this unique hand pump that came with the rifle, where you'd insert the cartridge and pump it up like a bike tire, which could then be loaded with either a 6mm BB or a special tail-stabilized projectile for increased accuracy. The result being a level of functional realism that has never been seen since in Airsoft, and which would ultimately be this rifle's downfall. You see, a rumor persisted that this rifle, with a few minor modifications, could be turned into a functioning firearm.
Oh my God!
The rumor, of course, was absolutely false. But with the level of realism being so high, it was believable enough that the Japanese government took action and collected every single Asahi M40 that they could get their hands on and crushed them into a pulp, with only a few examples escaping this horrible fate. So take a moment of silence for the Asahi M40, for being a trailblazer, for paving the way for future Airsoft sniper replicas, and being an Airsoft replica martyr that we needed to advance the sport. But this wasn't the end. It was only the beginning. In steps the Unicorn Hobby Corporation, better known as UHC, with their Super 9 Airsoft Sniper replica, which was truly the Swiss Army knife of Airsoft sniper rifles. The Super 9's party piece was its ability to transform. You see, it would come as spring-powered, but with a quick switch of the bolt, you could switch it to gas-powered if that was your preference. But that wasn't it. You see, the rifle also came with a rotary magazine that you could fill with up to 5 shells for a realistic, shell-ejecting sniper rifle experience. But if that wasn't your cup of tea, then you could switch to an external side-mounted magazine that fed BBs directly into the hop-up chamber, negating the shells, giving a level of customization hitherto unseen in Airsoft. And if we're being real, you probably won't ever see it again. And that's what makes this rifle so special. It's the missing link that shows the transformation of technology from a shell-ejecting cap gun to a soft air replica into Airsoft as we recognize it today. And even though while looking at this rifle through a modern lens, it definitely had some design flaws. It was front heavy, and the side-mounted magazine would always fall off, spilling BBs everywhere. Which wasn't that big of a problem, because if you had a scope on your rifle, you weren't able to load it in the first place, or fill it with gas. Which means if you ran out of BBs or gas mid-match, you would have to partially disassemble your rifle to refill, which is a functional nightmare. But despite that, this rifle has earned its place in Airsoft history. And around this time, we get the VSR-10, which is not only one of the most popular Airsoft sniper platforms, but probably the most copied, brought to you by none other than Tokyo Marui. With a lightweight, precision plastic construction that Tokyo Marui was known for, as well as an internal, removable magazine, and infinite upgradability, this rifle was the preferred weapon of any serious airsoft sniper, including a young engineering student from Vienna, Austria, who you know as Novrich, who started out making airsoft videos on YouTube, until eventually he started his own website where he had how-tos on how to make a scope cam, and eventually top-of-the-line internal upgrades for the Tokyo Marui VSR-10 and all of its clones. And not long after, he had kits for every other Springer sniper rifle on the market. Until one day, he released his own upgraded version of the VSR-10, the Novich SSG-10, which is undeniably the king of airsoft Springer sniper rifles and is the pinnacle of airsoft sniping. And that is where today's story ends.